Students, to my new lecture on the topic nuclear pore complex. So what is nuclear pore complex? The nuclear pore complex are the only channels through which small molecules, ions and macromolecules, it may be proteins, it may be RNA, that are able to travel between the nucleus to cytoplasms or cytoplasm to nucleus. The nuclear pore complex is an extremely large structure with a diameter about 120 nanometer and the molecular mass of approximately 125 million daltons. That is about 30 times larger in comparison to ribosomes. And it is thought to be composed of 50 different proteins that contains, and that is known as nucleoporins, that is arranged with a striking octagonal symmetry, that is octagonal symmetry. And the nucleoporins are made from alpha helical regions, beta propellers, and phenylalanine glycerins, that is FG repeats. Now, by controlling the traffic of the molecules between the nucleus to cytoplasms or cytoplasm to nucleus, that plays a fundamental role in the physiology of all eukaryotic cells. The RNA that are synthesized in the nucleus, that must be efficiently exported into the cytoplasm where they function in protein synthesis. Conversely, the proteins that are required that to be transported from cytoplasm to nucleus. So the regulated traffic of proteins and RNAs through the nuclear pore complex thus determine the composition of the nucleus and plays a key role in the gene expression. Now, the nuclear envelope of a typical mammalian cell that contain 3,000 to 4,000 pore complexes. If the cell synthesizes DNA, it needs to import about 10 to the power 6 histone molecules from the cytosol every 3 minutes to package the newly made DNA into chromatin. That means, on average, each pore complex needs to import about 100 histones molecules per minute. Now, depending on their size, the molecules can travel through nuclear pore complex by one of the two different mechanisms, by passive diffusions or by energy-dependent transport. The smaller molecules, generally, they are less than 20 kilodalton that passes rapidly across the nuclear envelope in either directions. It may be cytoplasm to nucleus or nucleus to cytoplasm. And these molecules diffuse passively through open aqueous channels that are approximately 10 nanometer in diameter, in the nuclear pore complex. Most proteins and RNAs, which are too large, unable to travel freely across these open channels. After binding to specific receptor proteins, these macromolecules pass through the nuclear pore complex by an active process, that is an energy-dependent transport, and that are selectively transported in one direction, either nucleus to cytoplasm or cytoplasm to nucleus. Now the traffic of these molecules occurs through regulated channels in the nuclear pore complex that in response to appropriate signals, diameter of the channel that is about at least 25 nanometer accommodate large ribonucleoprotein complex such as ribosomal subunits, and nuclear proteins are selectively imported from the cytoplasm to nucleus through these regulated channels, while RNAs are exported from nucleus to cytoplasm. Now, what are the nuclear import receptors? The nuclear import receptor, generally, to initiate the nuclear import, most of the cellular localization signal must be recognized by nuclear import receptor. And that are encoded by a family of related genes. The import receptors are soluble cytosolic proteins that bind both the nuclear localization signal on the proteins that to be transported and to nucleoporins, and they may form the tentacle-like fibrils. they may form the tentacle-like fibrils. Now, the fibrils and nucleopodies that contains a large number of short amino acid receipts with phenylalanine and glycines that called FG repeats, Now, FG repeats serves as binding sites for the import receptors. Now, nuclear import receptors do not always bind to the nuclear protein directly. Here you see the nuclear import receptors binds both to nucleopodins and to a nuclear localization signal on the cargo proteins that to be transported. Now, in some cases, additional adapter proteins are used to bridge between import receptors and the nuclear localization signals on the proteins to be transported. Now, the nuclear export receptors are structurally related to nuclear import receptors that are encoded by the same gene family of nuclear transport receptors or karyopherins. Nuclear exports of large molecules such as ribosomal subunits, RNA molecules that occur through nuclear pore complex and depends on selective transport system. The transport system relies on nuclear export signals on the macromolecules to be exported as well as on complementary nuclear export receptors. These receptors binds both the export signal and nucleopodins to guide their cargo through the pore complex to cytosol. Now, what is the model of the nuclear pore complex? Now, nuclear pore complexes are visualized by electron microscopy, and it is a structure of the eight-fold symmetry that organized around a large central channel. That is the route through which proteins and RNAs cross the nuclear envelope. Now, on the computer-based image analysis shows the nuclear pore complex consists of assembly of eight spokes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Arranged around a central channel, the spokes are connected to the ring at the nuclear and cytoplasmic surface, and the spoke ring assembly is anchored within the nuclear envelope at the sites of fusion in between inner and outer nuclear membrane. Protein filaments extend from both the cytoplasmic and nuclear rings that forming a distinct basket-like structure on the nuclear sides. Now the central channel formed by spoke ring assembly, that is approximately 40 nanometer in diameter, which is wide enough to accommodate the largest particle able to across the nuclear envelope. The central channel often appears to contain a structure that is known as central plug. Some investigators think the central plug is an intrinsic component of the nuclear pore complex that regulates the transport of molecules through the central channel. In addition to large central channel, assembly of spoke ring complex creates eight smaller channels between the spokes. These smaller channels have diameter approximately 10 nanometer and that are thought to represent the open channel through which small molecules diffuse. The free diffusion of small molecules and selective transport of macromolecules thus appear to be routed through structurally distinct channel of the nuclear pore complex. Now, if the defects occurs in the nuclear pore complexes, many diseases occurred such as the hematological neoplasms, heart arrhythmia, primary biliary cirrhosis. These are the reference books, Molecular Biology of the Cell, a Molecular Approach, Krapf Cells and Molecular Biology, a Global Approach.